Hi friends, today we are going to talk about proxy SQL. What is proxy SQL? What it can do? And before moving to proxy SQL, first of all, we are going to see how SQL query behaves. For example, you have an application server which is running an app A, and it wants to query your database DB. Now, what is the general perception that whenever an application is trying to query a database for read or write, it will create a connection, it will do its work, then it is going to kill that connection. But when you start doing this type of events or this type of actions in a scalable application, what is going to happen is each and every connection establishment has a cost in terms of network usage, in terms of time taken. So instead of establishing connection each and every time you want to query your data or you want to update your database, rather than doing this, what we do is an application creates an application pool. So when that application is starting up, it will create connections without using them. It will create empty connections to your database, and it will whenever application is starting up. So whenever it wants to read or write to the database, it is going to use this connection, do its work, and as soon as his work is done, it is going to release that back connection back in the application pool. So there is the case that we are saving on the connection establishment cost, because each and every API needs to perform in a very good amount of time. So we are saving on the connection establishment cost. Now let's move on. What are the other ways in which this pattern of using SQL queries is cumbersome or harmful to your application health? So for example, when your application is starting up, it will create connections to the in the connection pool, and these connections will be established on the basis of database instances IP address. So let's take this is IP address 1, and when your application is scaling or when the amount of traffic that you're expecting is growing, then what you have to do is you will add another database server or multitudes or multiple database servers. This is D2, this is D1. Now whenever new connections are being created in the connection pool, there is no guarantee that the number of connections to database D1 and D2 are going to be equally distributed. They can be equally distributed, they may not be equally distributed. And the number of connections is directly proportional to the queries that they are going to run. For example, if this database D1 has more number of connections, then it is more likely that database D1 is going to serve more traffic than database D2. And it is also possible that when these connections get stale, so for example, every connection that an application establish has a lifetime. And when this lifetime gets fulfilled, for example, let's say that connection lifetime is five minutes. When this lifetime gets fulfilled, this connection is going to get closed, and then your application has to create new connection in the connection pool so that the number of connections in the connection pool remains constant. So it is also possible that when this connection goes down or when this connection is killed, the new connection will get established to database D1 only, because there is no way to ensure that your connections are equally distributed. So in this case, all the traffic will be served from database D1, and the resource utilization on database D1 is going to be higher than resource utilization on D2, which is not serving any connection or any query. So that is how your queries are not getting properly load balanced across your servers. And even if you add a load balancer between them, it is not going to ensure that your queries are load balanced, because even if the number of connections to your database are constant, it is not likely ensured from the connection pool that each and every connection from the connection pool will be used equally likely. They can be scenarios in which one connection is used more, or some subset of connections are used more and some subset of connections are used less. So load balancing is the problem that we are trying to solve. To mitigate these types of scenarios, rather than having our applications directly connect to proxy SQL, what we do to our SQL databases, what we do is our application will create a connection pool to a new type of service called proxy SQL. This proxy SQL service or this proxy SQL application understands the MySQL protocol. So application will be initing during the init phase, application will be creating connections to proxy SQL. And whenever a query is received to proxy SQL on a connection, it will have proxy SQL will have multiple backend databases. It can have multiple backend databases, and proxy SQL ensures that connections, or rather than connections, but the queries are routed individually to the servers on the basis of different logics. It can ensure that queries are load balanced across the server. So for example, whenever we want to route or load balance queries between database D1 and D2, we can connect from our application to proxy SQL, and proxy SQL will load balance those queries. But here, since we have added another component, this component can become a bottleneck. You can think that this component can become a bottleneck. This component is not highly available, because if this component goes down, then even if you have two databases and multiple applications, multiple instances of applications, our service is going to be impacted. So rather than having a single proxy SQL, we can have multiple proxy SQL as well with the same configuration running on all of them. So this application can basically connect to multiple proxy SQL. They can be kept behind an ELB, TCP load balancer, because proxy SQL works on TCP level connections. And then these proxy SQLs will have the responsibility to load balance your queries among multiple databases. So we have removed HA. We have removed a single point of failure at the proxy SQL level also. But now you can think that since all our queries are being routed through proxy SQL, won't they become a bottleneck? Won't they have high CPU utilization, just like we encountered in the previous case with a database having all the database, a single database having all the connections? No, this is not going to be a problem in this case, because proxy SQL is just routing the queries. It is not doing any special work. It is just routing the queries according to the configuration that we have provided it. And all the heavy lifting on the data and the processing is being done by the database. So even if all the connections are made to a single proxy SQL, even then it is not going to have high network or high CPU utilization issue. And if you see that it is having high CPU utilization, you can always add more instances for proxy SQL. Another type of scenario in which we need proxy SQL, or proxy SQL can provide this benefit, is when we have a scenario in which we have multiple reads and writes queries, in which we want to send read queries to slaves and write queries to master. One of the way of doing this is handling this at the application level. Rather than having any other layer, we can handle that at application level also, that we should send read queries to our slave database and the write queries to our master database. But proxy SQL provides us an agnostic way that all our application has to do is connect to proxy SQL only. Then proxy SQL can handle load balancing as well as routing those queries to the appropriate destinations. For example, it can route read queries that are landing on our database to the landing on a proxy SQL to the read database, that is a slave database, and write queries that are landing to proxy SQL to master databases. How it does is that we have to write query regex or query matching logic in proxy SQL so that all the selects can go to our read database, and all the updates and inserts are going to a master database. That is how we can handle read and write proxy from proxy SQL to different databases. Now, this type of scenario also helps in cases when we have when we see that read queries landing on the master can increase CPU utilization or memory utilization on the master nodes. In those scenarios, we need bifurcation of read and write queries from master to slave. Another scenario that is very widely popular is there is an application B which is sending unoptimized query to our database, and it is landing to our, let's say, slave database, or it can also land to write database as well if those write queries are unoptimized. In those cases, what we can do is we can write routing logic as well as killing logic so that whenever there is a query or whenever there is a particular type of query that is proxying via proxy SQL, we can write a configuration change in proxy SQL so that all the bad queries or the queries that we think are not suitable for production environment should be killed at the proxy SQL layer. So these queries are not basically sent ahead. They are killed at the proxy SQL layer only. So that helps to keep our database up and running in a stable way. Another powerful way in which we can use proxy SQL is when our application is sending a query to proxy SQL, it can give an intent that what type of query is present, or it we can have query regex matching in the proxy SQL layer on the basis of multiple parameters. For example, let's consider a scenario in which application A sends three types of queries. One are the write queries that should be routed to master. Another are the read queries, which are normal reads, which should be routed to the slaves. And another type of query, yet another type of query is analytics queries. Analytics queries are long-running queries, which can have impact on a master or slave databases, but can be easily run on our analytics database. So rather than having this configuration in your application will send the intent to proxy SQL in the form of either comment, for example, analytics, select start queries, and then proxy SQL can have configuration like whenever there is a comment in the SQL query with the text analytics, then it is going to route that query to the analytics database. And on the basis of select and inserts or updates, it can route the queries to ma master and slave respectively. So in this way, you can have many ways of routing your queries through proxy SQL, and you can also load balance your queries across multiple databases and have a more stable and balanced system. This type of routing logic or query routing that proxy SQL provides can be used for database sharding as well. For example, let's say you have an application A, and since we were having only a single database, it was a point of failure. For example, if this database went down, then all our application is going to be unavailable. So rather than having single database, what we do is we have multiple similar type of database running in parallel, and all of them have some amount of data or part of the whole data. For example, let's say in this case we have four databases, or this way of horizontally dividing your data across multiple databases is called sharding, and each database individually is called a shard. So we have four shards in this case, and what we can do is we can have a proxy SQL with configuration that whenever let's say we divide this data on the basis of IDs. So whenever we provide an ID in the proxy SQL, all our application has to do is ID equals X, then along with the shard ID, let's say S1, it sent a query with the comment S1, and then what proxy SQL can do is rather than it is going to route those queries to appropriate shards. For example, it will be sending queries with comment S1 here, S2 here, S3 here, and S4 here. So this is how you can have a horizontal sharding or sharding logic using proxy SQL. This type of sharding logic is used by many companies, many top companies in India as well. So you cannot just have query level routing in proxy SQL. There are other ways of routing your queries through proxy SQL. One another way is user level routing, in which you can configure your proxy SQL in such a way that whenever user A accesses your application, then proxy SQL will send those queries by default to database A, and when user B tries to access access any database or any table, then by default those queries are going to be routed to database B. In this way, you can have much fine-grained control at the proxy SQL layer and let users work independently or agnostically. They don't have to know that there's a proxy SQL layer in between. They just have to connect to a particular database. In this case, that database pointing is going to be 3306 port on proxy SQL, and then proxy SQL is going to connect to databases on 3306 port. This proxy SQL works for MySQL database. And another pattern of using proxy SQL is this. In current scenarios, we have seen that proxy SQL was hosted independently from the application. Another way of using this is, rather than having independent proxy SQL, we can have proxy SQL running as a sidecar or as a separate process on the application instance as well. So, for example, this was application instance A, this is proxy SQL, and this is the databases that we have to load balance on. So our application is going to connect to localhost on port 3306, and our proxy SQL configurations are going to be in such a way that whenever this application connects to proxy SQL, it will send the queries to this database and this database in a round robin or in a load balance fashion. So the CPU utilization or resource utilization on both these databases D1 and D2 is going to be balanced. Besides that, what you can do is, whenever you are scaling your application A, proxy SQL is not going to be a resource bottleneck, because each and every instance that is running will have its own proxy SQL configuration, its own proxy SQL instance running on the instance itself, and it can connect to the databases. That way, we can have a much more fault tolerant in architecture. We are also reducing costs in terms of separate instances that we had to use for proxy SQL. This is called decentralized proxy SQL configuration. Decentralized proxy SQL configuration. And it will scale along with the application instances. So you don't have to have a separate auto-scaling logic for proxy SQL. As and when a new instance for application A comes up, it is going to have its own proxy SQL, and it is going to load balance those queries efficiently. So that is all on the proxy SQL front. Please let me know if you have any queries or doubts. I'll be happy to help you in that. Thank you.